this track?
I think, you know, first and foremost, you know, it was good to be at home, good to play in front of our fans, give them opportunity to watch this football team play. We came out a little slow, but, you know, I think in all three phases, we found a way to actually get the football where we need to get it offensively. We had some guys making plays. And defensively, we stopped the ball when we needed to. We let them get a few drives in there, a couple big plays, but we never did just totally break down. And I think, you know, with all our special teams, they did just what we needed them to do. They allowed us to play with great field position on both offense and defense. So I think it was a great team win. I had a block punt at the end that, you know, can't be tolerated and won't be tolerated. We got to get that fixed fast. Can't lose focus, you know, when we already have a game won and it's 50 seconds left on the clock. So we got to go get that fixed. We got to get it fixed fast because we have a quick turnaround. We have a game on Thursday night, so we'll get going early tomorrow and you know, work through Wednesday and get ready to go to Durham.
A little over a quarter in the season, and you guys are off the best start since 2015, 2-0 in the conference. How do you evaluate all facets of the game, you know, a month plus in the season?
I think we're getting to where we want to be. Still, you know, to me, too many penalties. Didn't have a lot of penalties, but we had too many. We had them in crucial situations. Had a couple long runs called back because of penalties, and we extended some drives for them with penalties. So I think we're getting there, but we're not there yet. So we still have some work to do. And I think in the next week or so, we'll start to see a totally different football team.
Jimmy, what is it about Morgan State? 6 touchdowns in 2 years for you. You guys like playing them or what?
I mean, like Coach said, we got off to a slow start. We got it in halftime. Adjustments we needed to make, and somebody had to step up. I just came out of the second half, and I was the guy that came to sit.
When you catch a short pass like that, you did, to start the third quarter, and you take it all the way around the field, what kind of energy can that bring to the team?
It can bring a lot, man. Just keeping our offense like rolling, and then our defense giving them a break.
KBS, when you have a playmaker like this, where you can get the ball to him and a short pass, and it can go all the way, and that's got to make your job a lot of fun.
Yes, sir. Like you say, you want the ball, then give him some space, give him a couple yards, just let him do the rest. And it's good to make me comfortable with just throwing him the ball, and no matter where he's at, he's going to never play.
What kind of adjustments did you guys make at the half? Obviously, the offense was kind of struggling there in the first half. In the second, and really the third quarter, you guys turned it on into the fourth quarter. What did you guys do at halftime, and what did you do different in the third quarter?
Just had to settle in and focus on play-by-play. Just one play at a time, because we was trying to make too many big plays at one point. So we just had to focus up and just let the offensive line and the receivers and the quarterback, well, offensive me and the running back, just let us know that it's one play at a time. We can't make a big play and come back and then make a penalty. So we just had to take it one play at a time and made our adjustments and came out and did a thing.
Your long run there in the first half, what did you see? I mean, it looked like you just saw green grass and just went with it. What did you see on the play?
I just followed behind Mallard, my tight end. He just set up a great block, and I just exploded out. And once I exploded, there wasn't nobody there.
Coach, you mentioned the quick turnaround on Thursday with Central. Obviously, when they were down here last year, it was probably the game of the year, double overtime, and national TV and all that stuff. Now you guys get to go up there. How do you adjust to a quick turnaround, and do you guys do anything differently in the next couple of days?
No. The thing that we have tried to focus on all year is to be concerned about things that we have control over. And we have no control over having to play on Thursday night. What we'll do is adjust our schedule. We'll practice, you know, tomorrow, Monday and Tuesday, and, you know, travel Wednesday and get ready to go play a game. So it's not going to really affect us any. It's just, you know, something different for us. And having these guys, you know, they love playing football, you know, so it won't be hard to have, you know, have them ready to play.
Marquise, defensively, a lot of bend but don't break. I mean, they were going up and down the field, but you guys made the plays when you needed to make the plays. You led the team in tackles. You had the sack. Obviously, Tiberius had the pick in the end zone there. What did you see defensively out there?
Well, we had a slow start in the first half, and, you know, came in the second half, made adjustments. But, you know, in practice earlier in the week, Coach preaches on doing your job, you watching, and, you know, make the plays that you're supposed to make. And, you know, the second half, that's what we did, came out, and just do your job, and work on your assignment.
Coach, you guys got Bird going a little bit more today, too. You led the team in carries and almost 100 yards. You guys had, in between Akevious and Bird and Isaac, and there's a lot of rushing yards. To be able to do that on the ground, especially in this conference, when running the ball is so valuable, what does that say about the offense?
Well, I say it's the offense that we knew we had. The things that we did today, and I'm not, you know, trying to sound cocky or anything, that's expected. We work hard. Our guys work hard every day, and those results are expected. We knew Bird would be the type of back that you know, he was today. He did the same thing last week. And, you know, and when he came back, he started carrying the ball, and he added a spark to our offense. So just pleased with his effort and, you know, his ability to change gears and to really change the pace of the game.